Well, this is another Wednesday night webinar. We had Bill Pescosolido on tonight. Today's September the 9th, 2014. He gave a lot of information to have an understatement on that, I suppose. So I took about 2.5 pages of notes. I want to go ahead and just quickly go through things, because if not, it's going to be a very, very long video overview of the night. So he wanted to talk about the major shifts that he had when he went from an average or low-end marketer to a high-end marketer making over $100,000 a month, making over million dollars a year. He had to change, one, who he was following and learning from when he was at his low stages, to go to the medium stages, to go to the high stages. So if you want to earn more money, you have to learn from higher-ranking people and more educated people. He believed that you had to invest in yourself and provide that value to others, and invest in your business as well. One of the ways he invested into his business, and he thought he had to do this big to make it big, is advertisements. He talks about now he spends about $9,000 total a month on what he does just on Facebook. Okay, so he has two accounts, his and his wife's account on Facebook. They spend $50 a day AP, so that's $100 a day in marketing, just for likes on fan pages to drive new traffic to his fan pages. He spends $100 a day per fan page, which is $200 a day, on page post engagement. So he does this to traffic his fans and new fans. So that's two ways he spends it. An average is about $9,000 a month. He says you need to target your actual audience and fans, because it reduces the guessing. You have valuable fans and loyal fans that like you and your business, so you might as well target them whenever you do advertisements. So, on top of this, you need to create new content and engage with your audience every day. Probably the most valuable thing you can post out is videos. So, create videos daily if you can, or at least 3, 4, 5 a week. And ask how you can actually help your prospects and help your fans out, because this will actually make them want to interact with you more. So one of the things that he did to get where he's at today, he determined his dollar amount per hour. And they say there's 3 productive hours in a day dedicated towards your business on average. So you take what you want to make a year, and you divide it by 12 for the months, then again 30 for the days, and again by 3 hours. So this tells you about how much you're worth. If you want to make $100,000 a year, you need to have value that's at $92 per hour. So if you're doing something on the internet or prospecting, you need to determine if what you're doing is worth at $92 an hour, or whatever your dollar amount is worth per hour. Okay? He says in order to do this, he has an acronym called DEAL. It's delegate, eliminate, automate, and leverage. Okay, so you need to delegate as many tasks as possible to other people in any way necessary. You know, if you have to hire a secretary or an assistant or something like that. Eliminate wasteful activities, because that just takes away your time for making money. Automate as many tasks as possible, and leverage anything that you can leverage. Okay, so a big thing he was talking about in addition to this is storytelling. You know as well as I do, you get hit with offers every day, so you need to do something that's going to set you away from all the noise that's made by people advertising their products and themselves, okay? So in order to do this, you need to be honest and transparent with yourself and with your fans, so they can actually see what's going on and they can believe you. So I'm going to skip a bunch of this stuff, but the main questions that he has on here is, what is the problem you're trying to solve for your prospects? You need to keep this in mind when you're making your story. What is the solution that they're searching? What is the outcome or benefit for the prospect? And when people buy, what's the outcomes? What outcomes do they get? And not what products do you offer? So the components of a good story is, one, the pit. The pit is where you go into details about your struggles, what you've actually been through, the pain. The next part is the search. So when you're searching, you're looking for answers to get out of the pit and tell about the solution that you actually found, whether it be on the internet or somebody told you about it. The breakthrough. So, which is the results of what you have found. So, this is initial results, whether it's you lost a few pounds by using a weight loss product, or maybe you got your first online lead or something like that. And the outcome is where you're at today. So, what this has actually done for your business, for him, his outcome in the end after finding this program, MLSP, is that he now makes over $1 million a year and his wife as well. So, they're multimillionaires. So, the next part is essential prospecting questions. There's four essential prospecting questions, but before you do this, you need to make sure you listen more and you prepare for conversations. So the questions are, what's your vision? What's the most important thing to you? What's stopping you from doing it? And what is the cost that you are having by not taking this action? So if you don't take action, what's it going to cost you in the long run? Whether it may be the lack of residual income, you won't have to work more to make that income, you're not going to see your family more, etc. So the last thing I want to cover real quick is follow-up strategies. I just want to run through these. So whenever you do follow-ups, when you're ending your initial calls, get a commitment for a follow-up call and be very specific with that commitment. Ask them what day, what time, what they're doing at the time, and be sure that they'll answer your phone. Okay, so build equity and be remembered. Okay, so don't just put out useless information. Give them valuable information that they can use. All right, so you can set up email reminders, add value in a personal statement or message. Make sure you call these people on time. Avoid any cliche statements when you open up conversation. Come in with a unique opening, whether if you're talking to somebody in the last conversation, something came up that's very important, that's business related. Check back with them on that. All right, and be persistent, polite, and professional. So that was a lot of information, I know, but if you liked it, email me at tkdblack2012@yahoo.com. Like, share, comment on the post, and ask me about my blog if you're interested in that. Thank you.